Hey, hello everybody. I'm here at the International Association for the Study of Pain World Congress on Pain. I am in Amsterdam, beautiful Amsterdam. This is a conference for almost 4,000 people here. And I'd like to introduce you to the overview of the new chronic pain classification. So what is this chronic pain classification? And what is the ICD-11 and everything? So the International Association for the Study of Pain, which is this group here that organized this conference, and a lot of scientists, a lot of researchers, a lot of clinicians, and patients living with chronic pain. The ISP got together with the World Health Organization, and in May 2019, they released the new ICD-11 classification. So this is the International Classification of Diseases. It's in the 11 revision, so that's the 11 version. Why this is so important? Because all the 10 versions of the ICD before this one did not have a classification of pain, especially any pain, and especially chronic pain. So what is so important about this one? It's because chronic pain affects a lot of individuals. 20% of the world population is affected by pain, chronic pain, pain that is ongoing. And it's 1 in 5 visits to doctors is by people with pain. So we do need, it's a major problem. And we need treatments for pain. We need pain to be taken seriously in the healthcare systems. So if we don't have a classification that is an international classification of the disease, because the ICD classifies all the diseases that exist that can affect human beings, if we don't have pain in the classification of diseases, pain doesn't count as a disease. But why should pain be a disease? Because we know, especially chronic pain can be primary and secondary. So chronic pain, first of all, is pain that persists or recurs for longer than 3 months. And it's often the sole predominant of the problem in some patients. And it needs a diagnostic evaluation, therapy, and rehabilitation. So the difference, why this is so important, is because the ICD-11 classifies, distinguishes between chronic primary and chronic secondary pain. So what is chronic primary pain? Is when pain becomes the disease. It's the disease of the pain system, okay? It is when pain becomes with an emotional distress, interference with daily life, and cannot be accounted by any other chronic pain condition. So it is a condition in its own right. It's the disease itself, okay? So when it becomes the disease in itself, we know that they are not like a symptom of a damage or disease of the nerves. It's not a symptom of something else. It's the disease itself. Here is a QR code if you want to scan this. I'll put the link in the video below for you to learn more about how this was developed. But this is what is important. MG30 in the classification of diseases, they come with letters and numbers. So chronic pain now, this is chronic primary pain, when pain becomes a disease in itself. And then we have other types of chronic pain. We have pain related to cancer, post-surgical or post-traumatic, when it's secondary to a musculoskeletal problem, when it's chronic secondary to a visceral. Visceral means organs inside of our chest or abdomen or pelvis. When it's a neuropathic pain or secondary to headache or orofacial pain. And the ICD also classifies the pain diagnosis and with some optional specifiers, like the pain intensity, the presence of psychosocial factors, and the temporal course, how long does it last. So this is really important because having a classification of disease brings us to a new era. We now can, pain is the disease, especially chronic primary pain is the disease itself. And this helps us, clinicians like me, scientists and patients, to get the right research, the right treatments, the right diagnosis. And thanks to the ISP and the World Health Organization, we now have a classification of pain.